The 13-inch MacBook Pro has been a big disappointment for the Pro users, as it has specs of ages old, but let's see how does it translate to real-life usage. So let's start off with the most controversial topic after Donald Trump becoming the president, the removal of the goddamn ports. There is a lot of problems regarding it, but in my opinion, it's not as big of a deal for me at least. I get my job done with the help of this Satechi USB hub, on which I have made a dedicated review which will be linked below. Well, the SD card slot is the only slot which I use a lot, and it wouldn't have made any difference by making this laptop a bit thicker and adding the SD card slot. Anyways, we can't do much about it. Let's move on to the build and design. It's one of the best built laptops. The full metal and that thin design is what I'm a fan of. It gives an awesome feel while using the laptop. The space gray color is an awesome addition to the lineup, which has also helped me complete my space gray family, and it looks amazing. I kinda like the removal of the glowing Apple logo, as the new one looks more classic and it's better than the previous one in my opinion. The display is pretty awesome on this laptop, and the panel is super bright, and the colors seem to pop out, and the color gamut is also improved from the last generation. It's one of the best 4K displays I have seen on a laptop, and it's great for color grading and Photoshop stuff. There is simply no pixelation on any corner of the screen. The keyboard is a second gen butterfly switches, and you will take time to get used to it. They are very loud while typing, and you sometimes feel that you are typing on a dummy keyboard, though you will definitely love it. It's the best thing I've ever typed on, and just like the 12-inch MacBook, it does have negligible travel. And once you get used to it, I'm pretty sure you'll not go back to anything else. Every single key has a dedicated LED, and the backlighting is insane, with very less light leak. The SSD on this gives you insane read and write speeds, and I've never faced any issues with transferring and copying files. It's a breeze, I must say. As you all know that Macs are not made for gaming, but for productivity work, but can definitely handle very light games such as Minecraft and other very, very light games. 1080 by editing in FCPX is insanely smooth, and rendering times are literally in seconds. 4K editing is definitely usable, stock Mac apps run extremely smooth, and it does reach about 40 to 50 degrees while editing in 4K. Let's talk about the just a full and huge glass trackpad. You'll never see a better trackpad on any laptop. The larger trackpad is a bonus, and you'll never feel the need to lift your hand up, and it's pretty useful in stuff like video editing and photo editing. Watching videos and movies is a delight on this laptop, with the awesome speakers on the side of the keyboard along with the awesome display make the experience amazing. So charging times are definitely the fastest on this. It charges in about 1 or 30 minutes, but the battery time is pretty high when you're using power hungry software like After Effects or Final Cut, and comes down to about 4 or 5 hours, which is pretty bad. But I get the reason to some extent, but if you do only light stuff like web browsing, it can last up to 12 hours. Coming to the performance, the specs on paper don't excite me at all, but when it comes to usage, oh boy, it's one of the best machines I've used. By that, I mean the performance on the Apple application and even some third-party apps work well, but editing on Final Cut Pro is a charm, and hats off to Apple for this fine optimization on such an under-spec laptop. So the question is, should you buy this? Well, not really. You'd better be off with a 13-inch 2015 MacBook Pro, which will definitely be higher spec and also have the required ports, or you can also go for this one if you don't care for the value for money part. Well, that's been it for this video, guys. Thanks a lot for watching. Click on the like button if you like this video, and subscribe to the channel for more awesome tech videos, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.